So yesterday I got the call. I checked out the ad. Whoa, you know, this is something. I've got a problem with this. I got a problem with this issue. I got a problem with politicians wanting to stick their hand in our pockets.
You know, it takes a certain type of person to go on television. You have to have the personality to be able to speak and to be able to project what you need for the people that are looking at you on television to be able to receive you. It's not easy, but it takes a certain type of person.
So yesterday I got the call. They said, Matt, are you ready? I said, what's up? And Joanna, the producer at Fox Business, said, listen, Elizabeth Warren's launching an ad against billionaires.
We're Americans, we want to make these investments. All we're saying is when you make it big, pitch in 2 cents so everybody else gets a chance to make it.
Wanting to increase the tax on the wealthy. I'm like, what, are you kidding me? So I checked out the ad and whoa. You know, this is something because I'm coming up. You know, I'm not a billionaire yet, but I'm coming up. And many of the people that we're in business with, they're coming up too as well. I've got a problem with this. I got a problem with this issue. I got a problem with politicians wanting to stick their hand in our pockets. And so anyway, one of the greatest ways that I've used to build my business to get the message out there about what we stand for is the media. And if I was going to share with you some tips on how to leverage the media for your business, whether it's social media or in this case, mainstream media, is to make sure that you do a lot of practice. You share your message. You have a constant way to constantly share your message at chambers of commerce events, networking events. You're constantly pitching and constantly finding your groove, finding your message, because this should be the first time that you feel strongly about a subject just because you're on TV. You're finding and refining what you stand for. And I think as you evolve as an entrepreneur, you find out, you know, what you stand for in our economy and our country. And if you want to use the mainstream media to assist you, to help you build a brand, to build a message, this is one of the greatest ways to do it, to be a value add to a topic that's out there. And you say, hey, producer, in case you want somebody to speak about this topic, put me on that list. And want to know a real good tip? Here's a real good tip. One of the greatest ways for me to put my name out there was during the holidays.
Here to talk with us about that is financial strategist Matthew Sapaula. He hosts Living the American Dream Sunday mornings on AM 560, a financial advice show.
Absolutely.
So with this interest rate cut and with the, you know, with this market going down and down every day, you think it's got to bottom out at some point.
Sure.
What do you, is it going to get worse before it gets better? Is it about the reaching the end here?
Absolutely. And you mentioned, Tom, this is a great wake-up call. This is, and hopefully we're dreaming with our eyes open here.
See, everybody's taking off on vacation. Everybody's in la-la land. But I got my name out there during the holidays, during the recessions. I'm dating back like 10 years. And certain regulars were out of town. Certain people there weren't just available. So I said, hey, if you need somebody to comment on this topic, because for years before that, I was doing seminars.
More people are taking off and moving up to the upgrade home of the starter home.
6 months before that, I was doing radio.
You're listening to The Money Smart Show with Matthew Sapaula.
Simple thing. I call this my acronym. This acronym is called SYSTEM. And SYSTEM stands for Save Yourself Time, Energy, and Money.
Today, you can do podcasts because, you know, 08, 09, podcasts weren't a thing. So for those of you looking to make an impact with your message on either social media or mainstream media, continue to speak your message, refine your message. What you're going to find is you can pull from many different sources to find out you. Find out your message and use these platforms to express it. I'm their apprentice, and I'm able to exploit this system for the best that it allows me to enjoy, which is really making a lot of money and paying my fair share of tax, but not. What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here. I just want to recap some of my thoughts here, my appearance on Fox Business based on the Elizabeth Warren proposed attack and proposed wealth tax on billionaires and millionaires. Here's a couple things why I believe it's an attack, why I believe it's really a murderous thing for her to do to entrepreneurs in America.
You've got a beef with the Warren wealth tax and all the other taxes. Spell it out.
Well, 100%. I believe not only is this attack on the American dream, but it could potentially, if this is, this goes through, this could be murderous and kill the American dream. There's so many different aspects, not only from the investor community, but also from like people like myself.
I think even Bernie Sanders said there should be no such thing as billionaires. I mean, that's an attack on the American dream. That's an attack here of the opportunity in the land of the free and the home of the brave. I think it does three things. Number one, if there's a wealth tax, there's a proposed attack on millionaires and billionaires. Number one, it would stifle the economy. The future people, the future folks that are entrepreneurs, the future dreamers and innovators, they might be stifled from actually materializing their dream or the advancement of America, the advancement of technology, the advancement of whatever endeavor that they're in to help America be an innovative country. If Mark Zuckerberg, who's worth $60 billion today, had this wealth tax been instituted since 1982, the year that Forbes was tracking estimated wealth, his net worth would be cut in half. If Warren Buffett, who is an $80 billion net worth billionaire, his net worth would be $10 billion. Where does that $70 billion of wealth go? So he made the money and he had to give up $70 billion over time to the American government for them to be stewards of that finances through taxation. Why? Because she wants to attack the wealthy to help the government, supposedly. We're here to be what we want to be, to do what we want to do without government involved. Listen, let us make our money. Let's pay our taxes. But please stay out of the way of stifling us in terms of growth. The other aspect too is it will shift contributions for people making charitable donations. Millions and billions of money are given to nonprofits, schools, churches, hospitals. You're telling me they're going to shift that giving from billionaires and millionaires over to the government? Listen, I'm part of the Marine Corps. I'm part of the veteran community. I know what it's like when the government comes in to administer health care, to benefits and plans like that to the warriors coming back from overseas and deployments. It's just not fair that it happened. Third thing, this is stealing the American dream. Folks like this that have a mindset like this, a socialist agenda, to say, you know what, you go and work, we'll kick back, but thanks for sweating off your brow. Let me take your bread. That's flat out stealing. And that's what the additional tax plan towards those choose to become wealthy, to become rich, to become millionaires and billionaires. That's what the socialist agenda wants to do to make sure that they have more than normal contribution to the rest of America, as if we're not already creating jobs, as if we're not already creating products and services, as if we're not taking an inordinate amount of risk to do so, to make this initiative type of happen. So with that being said, guys, thanks for tuning in. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Drop them in the comments below. Capitalist, socialist, Elizabeth Warren, Donald Trump. I'd love to hear your thoughts. I'd love to hear your feedback, because at the end of the day, the Seven Figure Squad is here to make future millionaires and future billionaires. I can't wait until I start changing the name of this YouTube channel from Seven Figure Squad to Eight Figure Squad, and then to Nine Figure Squad. It's your Money Smart Guy, Matt Sapaula, here from downtown Chicago in front of Marina City. Until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.